More now on Kate Middleton's shock cancer diagnosis this morning. And we're joined by Talk TV Royal Editor Sarah Hewson, who's live for us in London. Good morning to you, Sarah. The latest news that we've just had is a statement released by Harry and Meghan. What have they said?
Morning to you, Jane and Alex. Yeah, a very short statement from the Sussexes in the last few minutes or so, wishing health and healing to Kate and the family, and hoping that they are able to do so privately and in peace. It's a gesture, but I think it's a small gesture. And I think any hopes of reconciliation, despite this really awful news about the Princess of Wales, whether that's going to bring those two sides back together, I think that's not going to happen at this stage. I think the wounds run really, really deep. And I think William is so protective of his wife at the best of times, but not least of all now, and feels very strongly about the hurt that was caused to her by Harry's book and, of course, by the Netflix documentary.
And also, this has been around now for a couple of hours now, just breaking as we're waking up here in Australia. Your reaction to this news, first of all, I just want to go back a bit to this breaking this morning, because we're still in shock here in Australia. What's it like where you are?
So are we, Alex, because we had been hoping that the Princess of Wales was doing well in her recovery and that we would be seeing her back to public duties after the Easter holidays. And, you know, we'd had those sightings of her. And then today to hear this devastating news that she has received a cancer diagnosis. And the statement that she made, I thought it was heartbreaking. I thought it was emotional. It was selfless, as she expressed her solidarity with others going through this and told them they were not alone. But the most poignant part of it for me was the fact that they'd chosen to release this statement now, today, because it's the day that their three children, George, Charlotte and Louis, have broken up from school for the Easter holidays. And by doing it this afternoon, this evening, it means they can kind of wrap those children in a bubble and protect them from all of the gossip and speculation, that they can answer the questions in their own way. And they talked about having to have that time in order to tell the children, and Kate wanting to reassure the children, I am well, I'm going to be well, I'm doing okay. And that was really heartbreaking, because over the past few weeks and months, I think sometimes it's been forgotten that at the centre of this is a woman, a mother, a wife and a family who are all dealing with the most devastating and shocking of news.
Yeah. And while they've been dealing with that, they've also been facing all that speculation and pressure from the outside world, speculation over where is Kate, you know, why has she been touching up the photographs? Look, here she is at the supermarket, but is it really her or is it a body double? All of this kind of silly talk in many ways, while she's dealing with this incredibly emotional and private news. She is now asking for privacy. She's given people what they want. She's told them what's wrong. She's fronted the cameras. Do you think people will respect her privacy now?
Oh, they have to, don't they, Jane? I mean, you heard her plea there that she needs that privacy to protect her children. And that is what she and William have always been about, trying to protect the family unit and give their children as much normality as possible, but also for her own healing, to enable her to make a full recovery. And you're right, the speculation and the conspiracy theories have been wild. They have been completely crazy. And they haven't just been in some kind of dark recesses of the internet and on social media. They've spread and they've been on US chat shows. They've been celebrities, Kim Kardashian, Blake Lively, for example, kind of doing their own memes and mocking the Princess of Wales. And I think now there will be a lot of people feeling pretty ashamed. Now they know the truth of why we haven't seen Kate. And very poignant in that statement as well, she does point out that William has been by her side, because, you know, so many people have been asking questions about that too. And she said, he has been here and it's been a great comfort to me.
Yeah, absolutely. And Jane and I have both got young children, Sarah, and we just can't imagine what that must be like to explain to a young child that you have this battle, you have cancer. We've also got King Charles diagnosed with cancer recently as well. So two senior members battling this awful, awful disease. Where to from here for the royal family? How will they deal with this going forward, do you think?
Yeah, I've got three young children similar age to the Wales's children, actually. And, you know, it is the conversation no mother ever wants to have with children, is it? And they're also dealing with grandpa's diagnosis. Mm. As you say, Alex, this is the most incredibly challenging time for the royal family. We know that the Prince and Princess of Wales are going to be taking some time off now. We're not going to be seeing them on Easter Sunday with the rest of the royal family attending church. They are going to be spending the holidays, some 3 weeks, with their children privately. And Prince William will be back to work after that. But there's an enormous weight on his shoulders right now, carrying the weight of responsibility of the royal family, both he and Queen Camilla, while they are both supporting their respective spouses through their treatments and trying to keep everything going. It is incredibly challenging. This is just an unprecedented time for the royal family, and my heart goes out to all of them.
Beautifully said.
As does ours.
Yeah. Well done, Sarah. Thank you so much for being with us.
Great to talk to you.
Let's bring in US correspondent Lauren Tomasi now in Los Angeles. Lauren, we've just heard from Prince Harry and Meghan.
We have, Jane. Good morning to you. Prince Harry and Meghan issuing a statement just moments ago. It is a short statement reading, "We wish health and healing for Kate and the family and hope they are able to do so privately and in peace." Just one line, but a lot of meaning from Kate's brother-in-law. Prince Harry and his wife Meghan there, the couple of course live here in California in the United States. We know that when King Charles had his cancer diagnosis, Prince Harry made that whirlwind trip across to the UK. Now, as to whether or not he and or Meghan will travel across to the UK once again in a show of support for Kate, we don't yet know. But this diagnosis certainly leaving shockwaves right across America and the world just moments after Kate's diagnosis was made public. The White House expressing their solidarity with the royal family. And on behalf of the Biden administration, Karine Jean-Pierre there, the head of press here for the White House, saying all of us just heard this terrible news. Our thoughts are with the Duchess of Cambridge and her family members and friends during this incredibly difficult time. There has been so much speculation as to Kate's whereabouts. Certainly in the wake of that photograph incident, there's been talk show hosts, celebrities all speculating, and today that diagnosis coming, and it has been an enormous point of discussion. Sadness and sympathy exploding here in the United States and right around the world, Jane.
Lauren Tomasi there in Los Angeles. Thank you.